When I put on my very best German accent to say Hamburg, a lot of Germans tell me that they hear me saying Hämburg, and yet I can very clearly hear the difference. Some will go on to tell me that the syllable ham rhymes with the English word hum, but when I listen to native German speakers, that's not at all what it sounds like. Meanwhile, I genuinely can't hear the difference between my pronunciation of Hamburg and the way that a native speaker pronounces it. To me, they sound exactly the same. Which raises the question, what's going on here? Well, I think I may have a partial explanation, but it is going to involve a little elementary phonetics, so brace yourselves. This is going to get technical. I should first mention, though, that although I am going to do my very best to demonstrate all the various sounds, I am not a native speaker of German, and so I won't get all of the German sounds exactly right. Also, because the acoustics in this room are pretty bad, I'm actually using a couple of AI tools to help clean up the audio, and so that might also interfere a little with what you actually hear. So, first I need to introduce you to the International Phonetic Alphabet, which is a special alphabet used by linguists to describe pronunciations. For example, if I were to say the name of this channel in my native British accent, Rewboss, this is what that looks like. But if I say it in an American accent, Rewboss, it looks slightly different. And by British and American, I mean the standard dialects of both, which is received pronunciation for British English and general American. But in this video, I'm going to be talking about received pronunciation because I'm British, so sorry Americans, but I don't want to turn this into a 45-minute lecture. Also, my American accent sucks. The next thing is the vowel chart, which is based on a cross-section of the human mouth, specifically this part here. So we can construct a grid like this and use it to categorize all the vowel sounds. The thing that most affects vowel sounds is the position of the tongue, and we can plot that on the chart. Here are the vowel sounds for received pronunciation. The top of the chart represents close vowels, the bottom represents open vowels. Vowel sounds to the left are front vowels, and those to the right are back vowels. So, for example, the vowel sound in the word sit is a close front vowel, while the vowel sound in dress is an open mid front vowel. And we can add IPA symbols to the chart like this so that we can keep everything straight in our minds. And by the way, symbols that appear to the left of a dot indicate vowel sounds that are pronounced with straight lips, while those to the right are pronounced with rounded lips. That's the difference, for example, between ah and aw. Now, those are the pure vowel sounds in standard British English. If we compare them to the vowels in standard German, you can see that they don't exactly match. Each language has vowels that don't exist in the other language. If you're not a native speaker of a particular language, you may have difficulty pronouncing and even accurately hearing the vowel sounds that don't exist in your native language. And the closer that two vowel sounds are on the chart, the more similar they are. But it's still not very accurate. These charts show the approximate positions of the vowel sounds in theory, but the reality is a little bit more complicated than that. I'm actually going to move the vowels around a little bit to something that might be a little bit more realistic, but keep your eyes on these two vowels in particular. Most of the vowels have shifted a little, but these two have really gone on a journey. Now, the International Phonetic Alphabet does have a complicated system of extra little signs that you can add to get a more accurate fix on the vowel sounds, but you have to remember that there is basically an infinite number of possible sounds and only a finite number of symbols. It doesn't help that individual people's pronunciations vary quite a lot, and also, there's actually quite a lot that we don't know about phonetics, and occasionally linguists will even argue over exactly which sounds are being pronounced and how. For example, if I pronounce this word in a standard British accent, it comes out as approximately hat. But I'm from the English West Country, and so I pronounce it, I think, a little more open, hat. At least I think that's what it is, but in any case, you can see that I've put an extra little sign there to indicate that the vowel is pronounced slightly more open than normal. Also, I was taught phonetics at a British university by a Canadian tutor, which really didn't help. But let's finally get to the point and just concentrate on these vowels. On the English side, we have met, mat, and mut. And on the German side, we have Messe and Masse. But this still isn't accurate because, and I hope you've been keeping notes, real life isn't as neat and tidy as these diagrams make it seem. This is what I think is a more realistic depiction of what's happening. We all have our individual accents, and so in reality, vowel sounds are not points on the chart, but regions that sometimes overlap. If I put these diagrams together, we'll get something like this. And if you've been following on with this video so far, you should now begin to see the issue. Our vowel systems don't match. Most importantly, German doesn't even have the vowel sounds that we have in English in the words cap and cup. And so it's hardly surprising that in both speaking and listening, Germans will instinctively replace them with the nearest German equivalents, making kep and cup. And this is the key to why Germans have difficulty hearing the difference between man and men, and why I can't tell the difference between the way that I say Hamburg and the way that Germans say it. Listen to German native speakers, German native German speakers. So, for example, the vowel sound in the word swirls that doesn't. Now, it doesn't help that individual.